senior members. And then, of course, we have a resident organist here, Alan Matthew, who's put together today's programme. So we have a varied selection of pieces of music. And each organist is going to do, I think it's a favourite thing, but it's one that we'll all know each. And so please feel free to join in with that and enjoy. We've got an amazing, beautiful organ here to listen to, and these guys will put it through his pieces, so I think it's a treat. So again, welcome everybody.
Thank you. just hear that almost gives me a promotion, because there's some people here who might not know that I am, and wonder who is that person standing up talking. Graham Stokes is going to come forward now and give us, his programme looks quite simple, because there's only three items on it, but it's anything but simple. He's going to come up here without any music, and he's going to improvise for three sets of 5 minutes. Which is why there's a little clock on the top of the organ today, so that he can time himself. Graham was over at Good Friday, and I don't know how long it seems to you, Graham, but you played for almost an hour without stopping on Good Friday. And once he sits at the organ, his imagination and ingenuity just takes over. So, as I say, his programme looks quite simple, but it's anything but. And he will definitely explore the tones and colours of the organ. No offence, Ronan, better than you and I can do when you're sitting looking at music which is pre-written and tells us what to do. And after that, we'll all sing together, "Here I am, Lord, I am Lord of Sea and Sky." Grail.
Just set a little recorder, because I never know what I've played until after it's been played, which is a bit difficult. And improvising, I've heard it said that it's, to some extent, composing on the fly. I think at my age it's probably nearer decomposing.
Thank you.
going to explain a little bit about what I'm going to play. The theory behind it is I know what it's supposed to do. The organ is a large organ. It's only got 16 stops, but it sounds much larger than it is. There's varying reasons for that. Probably due to the fact that everything that it's got is particularly good. And in organist terms, you would call it a large scale set of pipes, which means they're quite loud. They could be scaled down to make them quieter, but then that would take away from what it is. As you look at the organ, on your left, is what's called the swell. You can't see the swell pipes, they're behind the coloured pipes at the front, and that's the box that you has got louvers at the front of it where you can vary the volume, rather the volume control. The first piece that I'm going to play, you're going to hear the two sides of the organ. So that's the introduction from the Sweet Gothic, which uses almost every stop that the organ has. And the couplers, which means it plays in octaves as well. So instead of one note, you get three for the price of one. And it alternates between the two manuals, the two keyboards on it, so you'll get to hear the whole organ all together, and you'll get to hear the swell. So you should hear it shift left to right, or right to left, and the swell box will be closed, so it should be in the distance. That's the theory behind it. The prayer in Notre Dame is a lovely little thing, and it explores different colours of the organ. The prelude on the Rosinitri, it's actually in the old hymn book, if anybody's got CHD kicking about. It uses the flute stops and some string stops. I had to put the next one in because I'm going to say it's personal to me, not the bit of music, but the stop that it uses. I became organist here 2.5-ish years ago. It all didn't work. So I came here in a wing and a prayer and hope that it was all one day fixed. And the stops that were silent actually sounded quite good. So the oboe, I didn't hear speak until the work that was conducted in 2015. And it is quite nice, and both Ronan and Graham have used it. The Benedictus, I just like it. It's up to time. But finally, the tubitune, it doesn't have a solo lead stop, so you've got to play about with it to make it sound as if it does. So this uses as the tuba stop the two lead stops which are on the swell, which is the horn and the oboe, but also using the game score just to give it a little bit of brightness. But it also uses those couplers that I mentioned before, so instead of one note you get an octave above and an octave below, which makes it sound a lot fuller and hopefully tuba-like instead of a horn and an oboe masquerading as one. So anyway, that's enough for me. Oh, it's got a bit of gadgetry on it, which I'm going to use. It can play itself. In June, it's not playing itself, I'm doing it today. But I'm going to use the transposer option on it, which is quite handy to have. I've got a nice wee kind of fancy version of Thine Be the Glory, which is the hymn at the end of my little set, but it's written in the key of D, and it's written in the key of E in the hymn book, which means I'm not that smart to transpose it off the top of my head, so I'm going to show off, and this is my reason for doing it. The transposer option on it, so it will sound in the right key, but I'm not physically playing it in that key. But then the last verse, which is customary here in Bellshill, it's a little kick up the bum, and then the next key, and I am doing that myself.
first new